Feral hogs are an exotic invasive species that have many negative impacts on both humans and the environment. Land managers have a variety of tools available for managing feral hogs. Box traps are a tool that land managers can use to reduce feral hog populations on their property. In this video, we will discuss structural modifications that can be made to improve the effectiveness of box traps. Box traps offer several great features that make them useful in feral hog management. They are easily moved and operated by one individual and can be placed virtually anywhere. The traditional box trap is typically 4 feet wide by 8 feet long with a 24 to 36 inch entrance. The dimensions of this traditional design limit its trapping potential since only a few hogs can enter the trap before it is triggered. The enclosed nature of the trap also presents a hazard to non-target species such as deer, which can be injured while attempting to escape. Research suggests that corral traps are more efficient in capturing feral hogs than box traps. However, some situations and environmental conditions preclude the use of corral traps, making box traps a viable alternative. Several modifications can be made to box traps to improve their effectiveness and safety. These include increasing the size of the trap, using fencing panels with 4-inch by 4-inch squares, increasing the size of the entrance door, removing the floor from the trap, removing a section of the roof, adding an inward opening rear loading door, and adding a locking mechanism to the doors. Box traps are often built using a variety of fencing panels. Using fence panels with 4-inch by 4-inch squares throughout will ensure that all hogs captured will remain in the trap. A piglet that escapes today can be reproductively capable at 6 to 10 months of age, so it's important to ensure that hogs are not able to escape through the trap's panels. Increasing the size of the trap allows for more of an effective trapping area by increasing the distance between the entrance and the trigger mechanism. A larger trap will also allow for the addition of further modifications that will increase its effectiveness. Adult feral hogs can be reluctant to enter small or confined entry points. Expanding the entrance area of a box trap from the traditional 24 to 36 inches to 48 or 60 inches will allow hogs of all sizes to easily enter the trap. Removing the floor from the trap gives it a more natural look and feel to the hogs. The installation of rooter bars spaced 6 inches from the side and running the length of the trap prevent the hogs from escaping by digging out from beneath the trap. Removing a section of the roof from the center of the trap can allow non-target species such as deer to escape. Panels that cover the corners and extend from each end of the trap prevent the hogs from jumping out. Adding an inward opening rear loading door allows you to safely load the hogs onto a trailer for live sale or to allow for non-target species to safely escape. The rear door opening should be slightly elevated, which will allow it to function in the event of debris or mud buildup along the edges of the trap. In Texas, both male and female feral hogs can be sold to approved holding facilities. Additionally, males can be sold to authorized hunting preserves. Both holding facilities and hunting preserves are inspected and regulated by the Texas Animal Health Commission. Once inside the trap, feral hogs will typically put the most pressure on the entrance. Continuous catch gates offer the potential for trapped hogs to escape. Adding a locking mechanism to your trap's doors will prevent unintentional escapes. In this video, we have suggested some modifications to improve the effectiveness and safety of box traps. Trapping hogs is a process, not an event. It's important to understand each step in the trapping process. For more information on trapping feral hogs, visit our website, Coping with Feral Hogs, at feralhogs.tamu.edu.